Welcome to S&P Global Platts Insight, where we examine the forces shaping and driving commodity markets today. Global steel markets have endured a fairly lackluster second quarter to date, with ample supply and tepid downstream demand putting pressure on steel prices. It's been a mixed bag for key steel end-user segments. In the US, housing has been soft, but the auto sector improved. In Europe, car sales and manufacturing were weak, but construction rallied. In China, manufacturing perked up in April after several soft months, and strong excavator sales suggest a decent pipeline of construction activity, which will support demand for long steel. Many market participants are looking to Q3 for signs of an improvement, but are they right to, as there are a number of worrisome factors looming? Firstly, there is always a slowdown in Europe and North America in July to August because summer holidays are dense steel demand. But perhaps the biggest concern is that perennial issue, Chinese steel overcapacity. Crude steel production over January to March of 232 million tonnes was up 10% on last year, as China relaxed its output curbs on mills for environmental reasons. Further, China is bringing on new capacity this year. Platts calculates that China will commission around 50 million tonnes a year of new capacity this year. Next year, it will bring on another 74 million tonnes a year, we estimate. Fixed asset investment in China's ferrous sector jumped 30% in the first quarter of this year, compared with growth of 14% in 2018. It generally takes around 2 years to bring new blast furnaces on stream and about 6 to 12 months for new electric arc furnaces. So, is China building another steel capacity time bomb? While this may be good news for iron ore producers, who are currently enjoying high prices due to supply shortfalls out of Brazil, China's international competitors will be getting jittery. If domestic demand is not strong enough to absorb all of the steel China produces, prices will be undermined by China lifting exports. Though they dipped a bit recently, exports were up 8.3% over January to April. Asian steel prices are already feeling the strain from additional supply in Vietnam and more competition from Russia and Turkey. The Chinese government will have to continue stimulating demand to help support its economy. This year, there has been renewed focus on infrastructure investment, but some analysts suggest this is just stabilizing rather than stimulating growth, and it may therefore not offer the same economic support as before. On October the 1st, China's Communist Party will celebrate its 70th anniversary. This is an important moment in China, and Beijing will want to ensure the economy is humming along nicely on this birthday. But it will also want clear blue skies in Beijing while the celebrations take place. This could result in mills being told to curb emissions, while some construction work could also be curtailed. A mixed bag, in other words. Whatever happens, there are likely to be a few bumps in the road for the steel sector this year. Until next time on Platts Insight, we'll be keeping an eye on the markets.